What is this stuff? Cheerio, mates. Trace Ear for D News. Earwax is weird and gross. It's basically congealed ear sweat. There are two kinds of sweat. Most is the cooling, watery kind, but some is the thicker, smellier kind, which shows up in the armpit, the ear, and a few other places. Earwax? Well, it's not really wax. It's mostly dead skin cells, proteins, and oils added by the apocrine gland. The junk is there to protect the inner ear from water or infection, and also to stop footholds of bacteria from entering your body. Earwax fights off some diseases and can lubricate and protect the ear from infection and water. It's a pretty common system of protection in mammals. The wax builds up over time, and in some species can reveal a lot about their past. Late last year, researchers at Baylor University used the earwax of a blue whale to reveal when it went through puberty, which years it was able to find a lot of food, and when pollutants like mercury were introduced to the whale's environment. Whale earwax isn't quite the same as human earwax, but based on studies like this, current research is exploring what this wax can teach us. This week, a study in human cerumen, the medical term for earwax, dove into the stuff nose first and found the smell of your earwax can give away your ancestry. Caucasian humans' earwax smells stronger than East Asian or Native American humans. Research published in the Journal of Chromatography B explored the ABCC11 gene, which affects sweat and thus earwax in humans. The type commonly found in Caucasians creates a stickier earwax and more stinky body odor, while the type in East Asians creates a drier, flakier earwax and usually less stinky body odor. It's not that the odors themselves are that different, it's the volatile compounds in the earwax. They're in different amounts. A volatile compound are the tiny particles that we sense when we smell something. Knowing this, scientists can use earwax not only to tell ethnicity, but in the future, they're going to try to follow those researching the whale wax and see what secrets your earwax holds. There are diseases which leave traces in the earwax once they appear in the body and might even catalog what you've eaten or where you've been based on molecules that get trapped in there. Doctors of the future might be able to diagnose a possible immune system invader or a health risk all with just a digital sniff of your earwax. Now, your cerumen is protecting you from infection, it's lubricating your ears, and it's keeping a health record for your doctor. But even knowing all of that, there are those of you who will totally want to get rid of it. Firstly, just don't use a cotton swab. Not in the ear canal. The outer ear? Sure, knock yourself out. Inner ear? No way! Sometimes when you poke around in there with cotton swabs, you're actually increasing the amount of earwax buildup. You're mushing it together. You can cause blockages or perforate your eardrum. Stop it. Oh, and ear candling? It's silly and gross. Studies show it doesn't even work. Not recommended. If you really do want to get rid of it, talk to a pharmacist or a doctor. They've got some drops you can buy. But why would you want to get rid of this stuff? It's great! Did we change your opinion on earwax? Tell us below in the comments and subscribe for more videos 7 days a week. If you like earwax, go ahead and toss us a like. Hit me up on Twitter @Trace501 if you have any questions for me, and we will see you around.